Declaring a class as abstract means that the class can contain incomplete members that must be implemented in deriving classes. The abstract class can therefore, in addition to normal class members, also contain abstract members. Any member that requires method body can be declared as abstract, such as methods, properties, and indexers. These members are then left unimplemented and only specify their signature, while their body is replaced by a semicolon. To show an example, we'll use two abstract methods, getArea and getPerimeter. When we now create a class that derives from this abstract class, it is then forced to override all of the abstract members. If we wanted the override to be optional, we would use the virtual modifier instead. The deriving class can be declared abstract as well, in which case it does not have to implement any of the abstract members. An abstract class can also inherit from a non-abstract class. If the base class then has virtual members, we can override these as abstract to force further deriving classes to provide new implementations for them. An abstract class cannot be instantiated, but we can use it to encapsulate derived classes. Still, an abstract class can have constructors that we can call from a derived class using the base keyword. If we compare abstract classes to interfaces, we find that they are similar in many ways. They can both define member signatures that deriving classes must implement, and neither one of them can be instantiated. The key differences are, first, that the abstract class can contain non-abstract members, while the interface cannot. And second, that a class can implement any number of interfaces, but only inherit from one class, abstract or not.